is I can identify the main ideas and key details in Ant Farmer. Turn and talk to a partner. What do you think the word identify means?
Based on our last
lesson. If you didn't mention that,
so I'll ask you, Richard. What do you think identify means?
Oh, to point something out. Or
to what?
To find.
To find.
Alright. So ladies and gentlemen, I want you to keep the word identify in your head. We're going to come back to that a little bit later. But first, we are going to focus in on some vocabulary words that you will be seeing throughout the text today. So, I wasn't really sure how many of you there were, so I have about 20 sheets of paper, and to be honest, I used child labor to do it, so they're all kind of interesting. But, so, for this section of the class about, let's say to you, your word is going to be mandibles. So be thinking about the word mandibles and what you think the definition of that is. From about here to here, your word is going to be fungus. So think about the word fungus, what it means, and kind of maybe where you've heard of it. The next section, so about here-ish. You will be doing colony, and your section is pheromone. So, these might be brand new words to you. So really kind of think about the reading strategies that we've used before. Think about root words, prefixes, suffixes. Think about the context. If we're talking about ant farmers, what do you think this might be? So you're going to have 1 minute. And on your little half sheet of paper, you're going to write down your word and what you think the definition is. So, 1 minute, go. And it's okay if you don't have a correct definition. We're just kind of activating our prior knowledge. Remember? Definition and crumple it up into a snowball. So, once you've crumpled this, you have 30 seconds to throw it around. After the 30 seconds, you do have to pick up another sheet of, like, somebody's snowball off the ground, so don't chuck it into the corners. Also, make sure that you look around you. If he smacks her with the snowball, you have to go sit in the corner. So, you have 30 seconds, throw your snowballs, go.
Give me one.
All right. So, please grab a snowball. If you don't have a snowball, just pretend, I guess. Share with the neighbor. And look at your definition. In your head, evaluate. Is this what you actually think the definition is? If you got the same word, did you get a similar one? So, be thinking. And now turn and talk to a partner. What do you think?
Release.
It's a natural, like, sense of organisms. But yeah, they are, like,
partners are attracted to the other's energy for most. If you don't.
I think that's pretty good.
Yeah.
Don't look so disgusted.
You're really good at countdowns.
Mandibles are the parentheses things on an ant's face. They use these to smell.
Excellent. So, just like she said, the jaws. So, can everybody show me your little mandibles, please? Mandibles. Excellent. Our next one is fungus. Did anybody talk about hear or write? A great definition of
nobody liked ours. I can't remember, I wrote it, apparently nobody thought mine was good. but it said something along the lines of, is either a living organism, possibly a bacteria, that grows off of a host.
You could be teaching this class too. So, fungus is a simple organism that is neither a plant nor animal and derives all its nutrients from other living things. All these definitions are taken from the National Geographic article. So, that has a lot of big words in there. So an organism is just something that's living. And it's living off of another plant or animal. Which is kind of a little bit gross when you think about it, right? You don't want to be like living off of something else. But, that's pretty good. All right, colony. Anybody think they know?
I liked this reason. Human colony is where humans live, so an ant colony is where ants live.
Excellent. Great connection. I like that. So, a colony is a group that lives and grows together. And later in the year, you are going to be, well, you guys won't, but the fifth graders are going to learn about the 13 colonies, so we're going to reconnect with that. How about anybody recognize at least part of the word and can connect it to another one?
Wow.
So, hormone is the word that comes to mind when I look at pheromone. And it is actually a chemical odor that can be used to mark a trail. So, it's not saying that ants are stinky. It's saying that when they go to a specific leaf, they leave behind a little scent, so that other ants can follow behind them and know that, hey, that's a good leaf. So those are our vocabulary words. So we're gonna go back to our target from earlier. So really quickly, class, would you state the target again?
Identify the main ideas and key details in ant farmer.
Thank you. So we're going to look at the word identify. Now, identify, the big definition of it, is to establish or determine or indicate the key information in a text. So that's kind of a lot of big words in there. So basically, if we were to break it down, it means to find the most important parts. So, raise your hand if you feel like you can find the most important parts. At least a couple of you, sir. So, when we are reading through our text, which actually it was cool because National Geographic you can access online, and so it actually can read to the students, and so when I did this, I did a lot of screenshots, that's why the pictures look all weird, but we'll get to the end of this. But when you are reading through, make sure you are noting the title. So that means I'm going to really look at ant farmers and see what they mean by that. You are also going to look at the pictures, except for maybe not these pictures because they look weird. You are going to look at the headings, skim through the text. Who can remind me of what skim means? Anybody remember skim? Not in reference to like milk. Excellent. So quickly glance through the text and look for repeated words and phrases. Then, after you've done all of that, you are going to carefully read through the rest of the section. So with my fifth graders, when we did this on Monday, I had them do an example. And again, they cut them out. I can do a little bit better cutting than they can, but only like this much. But so when we did it, I had them help me, because our read aloud right now that we actually just finished today is the first Harry Potter book. So we talked about what the main idea was of that chapter that we were reading. And then we went through and what are the key details. So we wrote down key details based on that. But I figure you guys can do that. So what I want for the rest of our time is you and a partner are going to partner read. You are going to switch off after every paragraph and make sure you are looking for the key vocabulary words. When I had the kids do it, every time they found a vocabulary word, they were supposed to go like this. Because it was like, hey, you found one. But you don't have to do that. So as you go through, please fill out what you think the overall main idea is of the whole little article, and then three key details to support it. Now, just like our little table up here, if your key details don't support your main idea, you won't have a table. So, do I make them actually read through, or is it okay?
You're at 12 minutes, so I don't think you need
to. Cool. So you just now have souvenirs.